try this again. Hey, what's up? Sporting the long johns today because it decided to go down to 40 degrees last night. I'm a little off. Little off today. This is the Stedman Pro. And I was going to do another video on something else, but it seemed to want to be shown. So, here it is. It does okay. I've been playing it for a while. That's why it freaking finally went out. But she did okay. I can't remember where the... I'm not sure if these are the original freaking keys or not. Machine heads. But, yeah, this is it. This was the monster of monsters. And the reason why it was the monsters of monsters is because it was only like $130. It was like $150, $130. I think this was smashed to shit. And that's why the guy gave me a break on it when I went and I picked up the... $30 unit. See if I could show you the finish on this goddamn thing. I mean, it's really hard to tell the figuring on it because it is. I mean, it really does look 3D, so I'm pretty sure it's a veneer, and they did a really good paint job on the frickin' veneer, and I can't complain. Right now I'm running through that, what is this thing, the Pandora PX4. The PX4. Remember the PX4? So anyway, I got that. My old man decided to leave his up here, so I have mine and his to play with. There's a setting on there that says 80s tweed. So I just went in there and modified the living crap out of it and then got it to do this. And now I have it running through the Marshal 12. To give it a little bit of an added whatever. There's not a lot of bottom on it. I'm also using it as a practice. Also using it as a practice, so it's not like, you know, it's not like, I don't know. I'm using it as a practice, so.
Mm-hmm.
It's hard. It's a little bit weird because it's like all electronics going on, and you know, this transistor stuff is a little finicky, but I'm trying to get used to it, and it's not easy. So, it's got the crazy buzzing going on and all of that stuff, which is what it is. I have the gain all the way up and stuff like that, and gain on there and whatnot. But, I haven't really tried to go too nuts with it because I just broke it out again, you know, to play it. That, and I've been watching whatchamacallit, Johnny Winter. I'm on a freaking Johnny Winter kick, watching him freaking, you know, watching him relive, you know, the late Johnny Winter. And he was just badass. I mean, he really did. I watched him one time. On he came out on stage with Muddy Waters for a while, and he did a couple of songs with him, and it was great, and it was pretty cool. I mean, watching him go out there and he was, you know, appreciated and stuff like that, so that was kind of cool to see. It was a little low, so he didn't really, there was no playing over Muddy, so that was good, you know, in a way, you know, didn't want him to upstage the poor guy. Muddy was already freaking, you know, he was already far. But I watched a couple of, he was out in Montrose. And Copenhagen. And then I was just watching one of the things where he was playing in Woodstock, and he was awesome, man. I don't understand how people couldn't get into him, but I can understand, you know, a little bit. So I got the 12 going into a dual 12, the Marshall 12 going into a dual 12. So, and it sounds really, it sounds awesome for a freaking, you know, for a practice amp and stuff like that. So, it's not bad. So this was, you know, this was what it was. This is the one that, you know, got a lot of views and everything like that, because people were saying how much, you know, a decent unit was. It's a bolt-on neck. It's not a set neck. It's a bolt-on neck. So that was that. But this one has, I've seen a lot of them where the neck wasn't the same as the body. As far as like the finish is concerned, it was not finished in red. It was finished in natural. And it looked a little different. They seem to be like Stedman Pros, but they're not Stedman Pros like this one is a Stedman Pro. So the deal is that this comes from overseas, and it's a low-budget item that goes from anywhere between 150 and 250, but and then what they do is, you know, a big box will come in and they'll take the top off and put their own logo on there, and that'll be theirs, you know. And you know, it's just that simple. It's made to be rebranded. So that, you know, that's what it is with the Stedman Pro. So you're the particular one that you hunt for, that you find a deal on eBay especially, may vary, you know, because I've been looking at them, and I've been, you know, because for $150, it's a great price. Get another one for that much? I mean, I can't hunt like for the same things like I used to. I mean, I wanted to, but my budget just says, you might as well just think about getting other things. So I'm thinking about getting other things. And it's working out that way. I mean, for you, you might, you know, only you can tell yourself what you want to get, right? Works great. These particular pickups are the SH1 Seymour Duncans. They're Seymour Duncans. They're SH1s. And H1Ns, which are the 59s, and which is fine. They slam. The only other ones that I was using for anything particular was the pearly gates. I can't find another freaking pearly gate. I don't know what the hell. I think I was trying to find something else in the meantime. But these are both 59s. So, does it sound like a 59? I doubt it. I mean, only a 59 sounds like a 59. This is not going to sound like, you know, Martin's freaking Beast or anything like that. I have absolutely no false impressions that would be the case. We'll be right back. like it. I think it does the job. I think it slamming, you know, and the way I finally got it set up and everything like that, and I think I got greenies on there. They're not anything in particular. If I have anything particular on there, there's maybe an orange drop on one and a regular freaking cap on another one. Was there an issue on... I remember there being an issue on the nut. Because on the nut is like freaking halfway on and halfway off the wood. So, but it's on there. I don't think I shimmed it. I might have shimmed it once. Looks like there's a shim under there once or twice. What I have is the plastic stuff, you know. I think I showed you guys the plastic stuff. But you can get stuff like this, you know, the plastics, and just cut the piece out of it and shove it underneath the nut. And it goes down so hard, so tight up against the freaking the wood that it really doesn't change the resonance. So does it have gristle? I think it sounds freaking well from here. You can't really tell because I got it all the way over there and I don't have it mic'd up, and I should have it mic'd up, but I'm feeling retarded lately in that regards. But it's a nice unit. It's a plywood guitar. Don't let nobody freaking tell you different. It's a freaking plywood guitar. It's not a mahogany. It's got a freaking cap on it. I don't know what kind of freaking cap on it is, but it's a veneered cap, and it's a beveled body, so it has all of that freaking, you know, bent freaking beauty rings and all of that stuff. The bridge was fine. You know, the tailpiece was fine. Haven't had any issues with that. They're HVMs, Hong Kong HVMs, which come with it. Which are not bad. They're really not bad. I think you heard it on the other guitar. They sound fantastic. As a matter of fact, the ones that I put on the V. When I put those on the V sounds great. I mean, there's nothing wrong with the V. In fact, there's nothing wrong with the V. Hold on a second. You know what I mean? And so, like I said, these are the HVM pickups, and there's nothing wrong with them. I mean, they sound fine. I'm going to say this, though. The neck, the whole setup has everything to do with everything. This whole soundboard, you know, the pickups can be crap, and the soundboard will make a freaking difference. And then the soundboard can be great, and then the pickups can be complete shit, so... There is that, you know what I mean? You have to, I personally think that get the soundboard to sound great acoustically. So if it sounds great acoustically, you got a shot at freaking getting your pickups to sound freaking awesome. But if you don't, then you won't. So that's my personal opinion.
Thank you.
So, the HMVs, the HVMs, they sound great. It all depends on what you're playing it in or over. So, I'd say transistors are always going to have a different characteristic over a tube amp. So, that's always going to be the case. But the transistors are doing a lot better these days. I mean, considering, who the hell was doing this? I can't remember if it was Seven Dust,
but I think it was Seven Dust that was actually using the,
that's actually using that as a practice thing, and they went out on NAMM a couple of years ago. They were playing in NAMM and at a booth or whatever, and they were playing the Korg freaking thing like it was a regular amp. I mean, you know, you gotta consider that, because if they're doing that, and you know, you have the Kempers and all of that stuff, and they're all electronics and whatever, it's all a combination of how you get it all set up. 183. Alright, so I'm just about done here, and I pretty much thank you for everything. Noise reduction on there, like all the way pinged to the top, so that's what you're hearing. Anyway, I've done my time, and I appreciate everything, and I'll talk to you soon. And that was the Stedman Pro, and this is the Dean again. So peace, I'll talk to you soon. I gotta go. Laters.